Hey, what's up, everybody? It's Joseph Ward, your historical homeboy, right here on the On the Shoulders of Giants YouTube channel. Thank you for tuning in, for checking me out, and being a part of this journey. We're here to give you the sung and unsung heroes of the African diaspora that you probably wouldn't learn about. So thank you for rocking with us. And I just want to let you know that we're now on Patreon. So you can become a patron and help us empower and educate as many communities as possible throughout the African diaspora. www.patreon.com/OTSOG. Now go ahead and get to this video so we can drop this knowledge on you. Peace out. Evelyn Dove. On January 11, 1902, Evelyn Dove was born in London, England, to parents Francis Dove and Augusta Winchester. Evelyn's father, Francis, was a barrister from Sierra Leone, and her mother was a British woman. From an early age, entertainment was a path that Evelyn had chosen for herself. She studied singing, piano, and elocution at the UK's oldest conservatory, the Royal Academy of Music, from 1917 to 1919. In September of 1919, Evelyn married a man named Milton Alfonso Luke. She also hoped to gain her footing performing in the various London concerts as a contralto. Despite her training, her skin tone was a deterrent to a number of London-based concert organizers. The worlds of jazz and cabaret would welcome Evelyn with open arms and offer her a place to start her career as a performer. Norma Winchester was the name that Evelyn initially used as the performer when she joined the Southern Syncopated Orchestra, or SSO, an orchestra comprised of British West Indian, West African, and Black American musicians. Black American jazz music was taking America and the world by storm and being recreated and performed by Black artists in the UK. Tragedy struck the SSO in 1921. 9 members of the band drowned as their ship, the SS Rowan, collided with another ship and sank. Evelyn was fortunate to survive the crash. She, along with other survivors, participated in a survivor's sacred concert on October 14th of 1921 to honor the band members who didn't survive the crash. Evelyn's career and her popularity were gaining more notoriety as she was able to join the American All-Black Review Chocolate Kitties in 1925, as she replaced the American performer Lottie G. The review toured Western Europe and the USSR. Evelyn Dove was becoming a household name in Europe from 1920 to 1930. She performed with London's Mile End Empire in 1926, as well as Her Plantation Creoles. Her Plantation Creoles was unique at the time because of the style of singing and dancing they presented to their audiences was unfamiliar to the masses. They traveled Europe extensively, performing in Berlin, Italy, France, the Netherlands, and much more. During their performance in France, Evelyn was able to replace Josephine Baker in a number of performances. In 1936, Evelyn traveled to the US to perform as a headliner at the famous Harlem nightclub, Connie's Inn. While in New York, she was photographed by the famed photographer and writer, Carl Van Vechten. Van Vechten's photographs of her helped to boost her notoriety. In 1937, one of Evelyn's performances was reviewed by the Evening News of India as she performed in Bombay, India. Her performances were so great that she received standing ovations and was being compared to the greatness of Josephine Baker. The two women were exposing the world to the greatness of Black performers, no matter what part of the world they came from. British writer Stephen Bourne stated the following about Evelyn Dove. She is an artist of international reputation, one of the leading personalities of Europe's entertainment world. She is described as the closest rival of the great Josephine Baker. Evelyn didn't just get the big hand, she got an ovation, a roaring welcome. Between 1939 and 1949, Evelyn worked extensively with the British Broadcasting Company, or BBC, as a singer and personality on a variety of programs during World War II. She performed mostly Negro music, but it was understood that she was more than capable of performing many different genres of music and could outshine her competition. She was a guest feature on the CD compilation Negro Spirituals, The Concert Tradition, 1909 to 1948, performing the Negro spiritual, Couldn't Nobody Hear Pray. BBC Radio offered her the opportunity to appear as a regular on music radio programs such as Rhapsody in Black, Calling the West Indies, Variety Bandbox, Music for You, Caribbean Carnival, Mississippi Nights, and Serenade in Sepia. Evelyn performed Serenade in Sepia with Edric Connor, a folk singer from Trinidad. The program was so popular that a television series was created from the radio broadcast. BBC offered their platform to display the television series Variety in Sepia to Evelyn Dove, Edric Connor, and many other black artists in 1947. The television series was created for the black talent that was heard on the radio or performed in theaters. Now, black, white, and other audiences were able to see the amazing black artists behind the music they enjoyed on BBC Radio. In 1949, Evelyn left BBC in London to perform in India, Paris, Spain, and other countries until late 1950. She returned to London but found it hard to find work despite her extensive resume as a performer and singer. She became a part of the cast of the London television series London Melody in 1951. In 1956, she played the mother of Eartha Kitt in the television drama Miss Patterson. Following her performance in Miss Patterson, she was able to become one of the performing stars in Langston Hughes' Simply Heavenly and a few other acting or singing jobs until her star faded. In 1987, Evelyn Dove died of pneumonia as a pioneer in black British singing and acting. To be mentioned in the same breath as the legendary Josephine Baker proves how talented Evelyn Dove was. Her voice was unique and brilliant at the same time. BBC radio producer Eric Fawcett stated the following about Evelyn Dove. She is a contralto with a perfect microphone quality, and although I have used her mostly in music of Negro origin, this has ranged from spirituals to Samuel Coleridge Taylor. She is, of course, a highly trained singer. She is an extremely charming person with a very attractive personality. I would rate her the best colored contralto in this country. Miss Evelyn Dove, we proudly stand on your shoulders. For more information, please visit www.ontheshoulders1.com or www.ontheshoulders.org. Please support the On the Shoulders of Giants book series by visiting www.ontheshoulders1.com and also support On the Shoulders of Giants on Patreon by visiting www.patreon.com/OTSOG.